After we were asked to make a documentary in class, we were faced with the grueling task of coming up with an idea for the documentary.
Firstly, I didn't want to go cliche by doing some topic that's already done. So this topic about e-commerce websites had come into my mind in the beginning itself. But the only problem was I didn't know how to shoot it. Since it's e-commerce, I had to show a lot of shots of computers and Flipkart and things like that. I didn't know how I could do a documentary on it. That's when it clicked my mind that how about I include actual retail shops and compare how sales in retail shops has decreased and how e-commerce websites has actually affected these shops. So then I went online and did a little bit research, and that's where I saw this article in some website. It talked about this shop, bookshop in Pune that closed down after 10 to 20 years of selling books, and they had to close down because they had no sales. And this bookshop was had a very good emotional connect to a lot of people in Pune. And this article, in fact, made me very emotional, and I felt that I should do something for these shops which is closing down unnecessarily. So then this topic came to my mind, and that's exactly why I want to do this topic. I don't know how far I've come out with this topic in showing the seriousness of the topic, but to some extent, I feel I have done justice to it.
At first, I struggled to find a topic for my documentary. So this one day, I was stuck in traffic and I was late for class for the second day in a row. So I decided, let me just make the documentary on traffic. So this topic of mine shows, you know, the mistakes and people commit while traveling, and which leads to traffic jams and, you know, arguments on the road. So yeah.
I thought about religious minorities in Dubai because nothing else came to my head. Primarily because everyone is either doing it on garbage or some Dalit children. And for me, Dalit children are not a very important topic. And then I was just like, listen, if you're gonna exploit Dalit children or mentally challenged, you know, same thing. You know, you shouldn't do that for like a CIA. And then I was just like, okay, fine, let's explore something else. And then I thought about my background, where I grew up, and religion was a big part of my life. You see, right now I'm actually gonna take a trip to the Himalayas for a spiritual meditation sort of thing. And so I decided to do on religious minorities, because in Dubai, you see, in Dubai, part of UAE, it's in the midst of a lot of Arab countries in which, you know, there's a lot of violence against other religions. So it's interesting to see how in this place, things are pretty going smooth.
I live in Jayanagar with my grandparents, and I've been coming to Bangalore for the last 20 years. So I think I've seen the transformation that has happened to Jayanagar. So I thought of maybe trying to portray what has happened, the transformation that has happened in Jayanagar. Although I haven't witnessed the entire transformation, but I've seen how Jayanagar was at least 10 years ago with the memory that I have of it and how it is now. So I thought I would, you know, just highlight how this transformation has happened and what are the basic things that have changed in Jayanagar.
After coming up with and rejecting several ideas, and after finally getting our ideas in place, we moved to
Bangalore is such a sleepy city, dude. All the shops are closed.
Yeah. What do you do now?
I guess we wait. What else? Stop it, Aki.
The problem I faced was I've been kicked out of shops. It's very disappointing. Most of the people weren't ready to face the camera, and they were worried that their jobs would go if people actually saw this film. So, I think that's the only problem I faced. Otherwise, it was pretty good. It was a good experience. Since this is my first short film, I think it's pretty nice. Actually.
the most important element of shooting our documentaries was interviewing people, and this is where we ran into trouble. While we were trying to interview people, we realized that some people weren't interested, some didn't want to appear on video, some just didn't have the time, and some worried about legal consequences. And sometimes, we were just too shy to ask people.
The biggest problem I faced when shooting my documentary was that people weren't ready to face the camera. So whenever I went into shop, they said you can't shoot inside or you can't shoot that particular person. I went to like 3-4 shops and they never agreed to, you know, come face the camera and talk about the topic. And since my topic is related to shops and outlets, it was very necessary for me to do something like that, but it's not happened yet.
Okay, so I basically gave my camera work and my editing to other people because I felt that it would, as a director, I feel that other people who are good at editing can do it better than I can. And not that I don't have faith in myself, but I am not very well skilled in editing and camera work. And the camera person right now is the one who did my editing. And thank you to her. Thank you, Akshaya.
So I use Adobe Premiere to edit my documentary. I had very basic knowledge of Adobe Premiere in the beginning, but then I had one of my friends, he helped me to learn Adobe Premiere. So along with him, I edited my documentary. It was actually fun. I liked editing the documentary. I feel it's a better experience to edit than to shoot in itself. We use a lot of effects, we use a lot of video and sound effects, the cutting and the pasting processes, it was fun. Yeah, I guess that's about it.
Pune's iconic bookstore, Twist and Turn, closed its doors early 2000. Pune's iconic bookstore, Twist and Turn, who closed its doors?
No laughing, Anjali.
Okay, sorry, I was just like Pune's iconic bookstore, Twist and Turn, closed its doors early 2014. This comes as a show.
Hi y'all, it's Evan Thomas again. Miss me? Okay, not so much. So I use this software called Cyberlink Power Director. Now this was a software that was already in my laptop which I newly bought. Okay, now I thought it looked very like fancy and professional, but what happened was once I started using it, it was very good, but it kept hanging. And then sometimes it's annoying because I didn't save like many times. And what happens is I have to do it all over again. And that happened at least 4 times. Especially this one day where that application crashed 7 times. Yeah, while I was doing it. So otherwise editing was actually not that hard as I thought it would be. I thought it would be like, super hard. And so what I did was, once I did the video, like just the video without the audio, I saved that as a movie. Then I opened the movie in this thing, so it's one clip, and then I put the audio. And then I saved that. And then when it's part of the whole thing, I again opened it to save it as to put narration. So I did separate. These would keep hanging if I did it all together at once. Otherwise, editing was pretty chill. We're not supposed to use that fading thing so much because it makes it look blah. But yeah, I still use that a lot, and yeah, hopefully I'll get some marks.